mean, with all the injuries, a lot of the young players are getting quality minutes with all the injuries. And they, oh, big hit there, Vitaly in the air. Look out.
Look out. He's ready, too. Oh, man. Shen's getting it from Aaron Asham. Shen picked the wrong guy there. Kubina steps in. Look, we got problems right now. Tony Granato right here going at it. Vitaly left. We're going to get up. We got it all going on here. Laviolette's furious at Bilesma. Yep. They're going after.
And I think what Peter Laviolette is upset about in a 6-3 hockey game, Dan Bilesma throws out his fourth line.
And Englund on defense, and Englund's got Simmonds, and remember, Simmonds was cut yesterday with a puck, and Englund's got the right hands going. They got to keep Clojure on the bench here. Don't get himself in trouble.
Craig Berube is acting the role of peacemaker here. In his playing career, he had more five-minute fighting majors than anyone, but he sees a powder keg brewing, and so he's gotten his coach back to the middle of the bench. Tony Granato, the assistant to Dan Bilesma, Pittsburgh.
So now Wes McCauley came over. Tony Granato will be kicked out of the game, and I think Laviolette's getting kicked out of the game as well.
We'll just peel back and let you listen there, Pierre, with the mic closed probably until you get more information, but we appreciate what you're doing down there.
That's as mad as I've ever seen Peter Laviolette. I watch him coaching Wheeling in the East Coast Hockey League, Providence in the American League, the Islanders, Carolina, now Philly. I don't think I've ever seen him that mad, Eddie.
Well, you saw him close up, didn't you?
Oh, I could hear him, too.
Well, Joe Vitaly with the big hit, and everybody on the ice saw the hit, and the puck was optional, and everybody made a beeline for Joe Vitaly. And this is a major, major hit. Good, clean hit, too, by Vitaly. And there you see Peter Laviolette and Tony Granato. And Pierre is an innocent bystander. Look at Craig Berube. You talked about making peace. Berube certainly doing a good job of holding the coach from going across all the way over to the Penguin bench, and then it's just a melee on the ice. Remember, Braden Schenn's the guy that cross-checked Crosby during that delay that we had with...
Well, it's all about...
The goal by Sullivan.
Well, they're really mad. Crosby's really mad about Schenn hit him from behind. Now we got Aaron Asham right over with Zach Rinaldo.
You
got
to be careful for up here, Aaron Asham.
Careful. I agree.
You get caught instigating a fight the last 5 minutes of the game, you're going to get some time. I mean, right now, the referees... They got to start sending people into the dressing room. If nobody's going to listen, you just start giving tens and you start throwing people out.
They will. But Crosby was going at it with Laviolette. Laviolette's no longer on the bench. He's been escorted off. So Kevin McCarthy will finish the game off with Craig Berube.
As a player, you cannot engage, and this goes for a coach too. You cannot start yipping and yapping at coaches if you're a player or vice versa.
Well, bring on the playoffs.
You better get some security behind the Penguin bench. You got people throwing stuff onto the ice now.
And Hartnell's kind of having some fun with them. They need to definitely get some security back here.
It's like Hulk Hogan's younger brother or something.
He wishes. Nimmo Tiemann and just said to me, I can't wait till next Saturday. He's standing next to Scotty Arnold, two former Nashville Predator players, Stevie Sullivan, who played Nashville with them, just on the other side of the glass. There's Hartnell taunting the crowd, and as Eddie said, Hulk Hogan's little brother.
And that was after somebody threw a couple of containers on the ice trying to end up into the Flyer bench.
He's looking for his mouth guard, Scotty Hartnell.
Classics, because they could probably put them in football fields.
Yeah, way back at 4:42 remaining in the third period, the cross check by Braden Shen. Then we had a video review of the goal by Steve Sullivan, and the Penguins were still in a hockey game, and then eventually the empty net. Peter Laviolette puts his line on the ice, and then Dan Bylsma puts his fourth line on the ice, and then the big hit by Vitali on Briere. And that's why this delay has happened over the course of the last probably 8 or 9 minutes, and puck is still in play, a good hit. But I understand what Peter Laviolette was so upset about the players on the ice and Vitali taking a run at Danny Briere. Pucks in play, Flyers, Penguins, you play to the end.